Scientists working in the fields of chemistry, molecular biology, and materials science have a powerful partner, the supercomputer. The supercomputer's power and speed in performing numerically intensive calculations catalyze the research process by strengthening the link between the computational chemist and the experimental chemist. High-performance software allows chemists to see many molecular structures and simulate the ways in which they interact. For researchers in the chemical, pharmaceutical, and petrochemical industries, supercomputers are accelerating the search for solutions to some of the world's most challenging scientific problems, such as the search for new drugs, identification of genetic patterns, and discovery of alternative materials.
When aeronautical engineers want to know how air will flow over one of their designs, they can build a model and test it in a wind tunnel. But thanks to today's supercomputers, like this Cray XMP, there's a less costly, less time-consuming way to evaluate their ideas. These ultra-fast machines, with incredibly large memories, make it possible to do timely, accurate simulations before committing to expensive hardware. And it's not just airflow that can be studied. Here, the flow of water around a submarine is being investigated. Even the flow of fuel through the shuttle's main engines can be examined. Recently, scientists producing these simulations at NASA's Ames Research Center in Mountain View, California, began using a new supercomputer, the Cray 2. Though much smaller than the previous generation Cray, it's faster than any computer in the world, performing 250 million calculations per second. It also has 10 times more memory than any existing machine. In fact, the Cray 2 is so powerful that its circuitry is continually immersed in a cooling solution to keep it from overheating. Putting this new supercomputer's capabilities into proper perspective is the manager of the Numerical Aerodynamic Simulation Program at Ames, Ron Bate.
What you see in this small tank of liquid in the Cray 2 is equivalent to a warehouse of small home computers.
The Cray 2 makes more comprehensive simulations possible. For example, the people at Ames have been able to simulate airflow around the shuttle orbiter itself. But the orbiter attached to the solid rocket boosters and large external fuel tank has posed too great a problem for any computer to date.
My daily routine is usually one of working alone in the morning for several hours, and then around lunchtime I make the rounds of the various buildings that I supervise, communicate with people, and that can take from just an hour to several hours and sometimes the whole day. But then if there's any time left over, then I end up going back and doing technical work again. I tend to work at home, just because they have better control of the environment.